coordenar essa mesa e tenho o prazer, enfim, e a honra de receber aqui para fazer uma palestra para nós, o professor Eric Stigdu, da Universidade de Manchester e professor do Departamento de Geografia. Né? Ele vai falar sobre justiça água urbana, água nas cidades, justiça ambiental urbana ou ecologia política. Né? Então, eu passo a palavra para o professor Eric e depois a gente vai tentar ter uns minutos para o debate. Tá bom? Agradecendo enormemente a presença dele e o deslocamento dele até aqui ao Brasil, até São Paulo.
Thank you very much. It's my pleasure to be here. I'm really sorry that I have to do this presentation in English. I can't do it in either Portuguese or Spanish. My apologies for that. Second thing is, I can't see anything at all. So if my talk is really boring, you can really doze off. I won't notice anything. This is a conference about water. But I'm not going to say much about water, actually. Although it will be very much central to my argument. My argument is one that is articulated around, on the one hand, the key theme of this conference, which is environmental justice. It's in the title of this conference, the tension between social justice and environmental justice. I want to tease out a bit this notion of urban environmental justice and injustice and confront it somewhat with a different perspective, which I call urban political ecology. My key point will be to consider the following statement. You may recall that in the 19th century, Karl Marx called religion the opium for the people. Today, I would argue that ecology very much, very often, stands exactly as this opium for the people. And that's where I think that environmental justice, which is an argument about morality, about what is right and what is wrong. And as Marx reminds us, considering things of right and wrong is the business of the elites. Justice is a word that sounds very well in the mouth of George Bush. I think we have to start thinking slightly differently and think about urban environmental conditions as inherently political ones. That's why I put up this slogan. No one has ever voted to die of thirst. And we all know, of course, that dying of thirst is the number one cause of premature mortality, that is, people dying before their shelf life has expired. So what I want to raise is whether issues of clear socio-environmental inequalities that no one disputes. You don't have to be a rocket scientist to understand that socio-ecological conditions are extraordinarily unequal and uneven. Walk around in Sao Paulo and you'll smell, see, touch it at every corner. So what I want to tease out are these questions of socio-environmental inequality, or that issues of environmental justice, or are they questions of political equality? Before I start talking about that, I want to remind ourselves that the environment, the physical, natural environment, has been for a long time an integral component of the urban It's only in the 20th century, I would insist, that many of us urban scholars began to see the city as the antithesis to nature and the environment. I would like to insist, together with David Harvey, that there's nothing unnatural about Sao Paulo. Sao Paulo, just like any other city, is nothing else than a particular socio-ecological process that produces a particular socio-physical environment characterized by extraordinary socio-environmental inequalities and exclusions. This was already very well known in the 19th century. Go back to how Friedrich Engels, for example, described my hometown, Manchester, in the mid-19th century, and how so many of his arguments about the condition of the working class in the Manchester of the mid-19th century were about the physical environment, health, smog, pollution, water, bacteria, and how the actions of bacteria, the actions of smoke in the air, were a matter of life and death, orchestrated by the dynamics of capitalist urbanity in the 19th century. And of course, we already found it in Marx's Capital, when he discussed the metabolic lift, as he called it, where he says that large landed property reduces the agricultural population to an ever-decreasing minimum and confronts it with an ever-growing industrial, we call it urban population, crammed together in large towns. In this way, it produces conditions that provoke an imperable lift in the interdependent process of social metabolism. This is the kind of work that could be said today by an ecologist who knows his stuff or her stuff. And it was not only Marx, other 19th century sociologists avant la lettre, that were sociologists before sociology existed as an academic discipline, were very much concerned about understanding the world as one, where the social and the physical were intimately intertwined. And I don't have to remind you of the bacteriological city, how the first attempts to produce a sustainable city were done in the late 19th century in the urban sanitation movements worldwide. If I'm not mistaken, one of the neighborhoods here in Sao Paulo is called the Hygienic City, which very much embodies this particular attempt, originated in the late 19th century, of sanitizing the city, making it socially, ecologically sustainable. But that disappeared in the 20th century. But I want to insist that this was a particularly 20th century condition in which urban thinking got split into two domains. There's the domain of the sociologists, and I still hold the Chicago social ecologists, urban ecologists, responsible for this criminal act, where they thought they could understand the city in purely social, ecological terms, totally forgetting, totally severing this link that makes a city really tick, that makes it really function, which is intertwining of the social and the physical. And this denaturalization of the urban problem that started more or less with Chicago School, of course, continued in what we would later call critical political, urban political economy. Where is nature in the works of Manuel Castells? Where is nature in the work of Helena Fairfield? Where is nature in the work of all the great urban scholars that we have come to admire and still admire? It's only in the late 20th century
tentar
that
entender
urban
essa
nature
cidade.
Became foregrounded again.
A natureza,
and that was not thanks to us very much,
intellectuals of the city. Isso não foi graças a nós, intellectuals da
it
cidade,
was because urban nature began to
posit itself as a clear problem.
Yes, there was some dabbling in the late 19th century of trying to design
uma tentativa no século XIX de tentar desenhar cidades com natureza, mas para mim o momento-chave que realmente trouxe à tona a ecologia e o problema social e econômico, isso surgiu nos anos 1970 com uma mobilização maciça contra a energia nuclear. Foi assim que eu cresci.
I became an urban ecological scholar through my activism in the anti-nuclear movement, and we won with a little bit of help from Chernobyl and Three Mile Island, for those old enough to remember. It's almost perverse that 30-odd years later, that this galvanizing moment of success is now turned around. In my country, the UK, nuclear energy is now embraced.
Hoje, a energia nuclear é abraçada pelos modernizadores ecológicos e também por seções significativas do movimento ecológico, como aquilo que vai salvar o mundo, que vai manter o direito de São Paulo de queimar energia nuclear como um salvador ecológico. Então, se a ecologia não é o ópio do povo, eu não sei o que é.
The alarmist reports, Malthusian in nature, of the Club of Rome and the specter of the soil's depletion.
Com a depressão do solo.
And all that, of course, in a
context
of a galloping urbanization.
De uma urbanização
galloping is
galopante,
not the right word. If I look at a city like
São
Paulo, I get lost.
Mas eu fico
this
perdido.
Is the ecological condition of the world in the 21st century. If we don't deal with that, we better go home and give up.
The
ecological problem resides in São Paulo, New York, Tokyo, Hong Kong, and any other city, not somewhere
São Paulo, Tóquio,
in Amazonia.
E não em algum
it's
lugar
here.
Na Amazônia. O problema está aqui.
So through that, from the late 60s onwards, a new
então,
sort of relationship began
60,
to embryonically
surgir,
emerge.
Very
tipo often sustained, and now almost hegemonically sustained today, by invoking this notion of sustainability. We got to produce urban sustainability. Who is against urban sustainability? Please stand up now.
Urbana. Quem é contra a sustentabilidade
exactly.
urbana
it's a romantic ideology.
Exatamente.
Predicated
é uma
upon
romântica.
A very particular scripting of what nature is.
Ela,
this more or less goes as follows. Nature is inherently good, inherently balanced, inherently all right.
Não seja aquilo que ela de verdade
the 19th century romantic notion. Of course, if I look at cities like Concepción or Haiti, or at the ravages of New Orleans, I don't see
mas
much benign acting in nature,
muito,
actually.
Muita atuação benigna da natureza, na verdade,
nature is
hoje.
Good.
Mas há essa noção de que a natureza
language,
inerentemente
what
é boa.
We need to do,
que somos
then,
nós, que, desculpem a linguagem, que ferramos
so
com a natureza. Então, nós...
Can be retrieved.
Essa natureza balanceada pode ser recuperada, essa é a noção geral. Esse é discurso de ideologia.
Of course, very often these notions of trying to produce a more harmonious socio-ecological configuration
uma configuração mais homogênea,
is very often, not always, and certainly not among us here, but in the dominant discourse,
no discurso dominante,
often neglects questions of inequality and persistent conditions, often worsening conditions of socio-ecological exclusion and inequality.
De exclusão e inequidade
and it's these relationships, the relationship between equality and inequality,
and urban socio-ecological dynamics that I want to tease out. Igualdade, né?
To briefly talk about three perspectives,
e and then conclude
with a few suggestions as to what we might want to think about.
Discutir.
First one is the one I already mentioned.
Primeira questão
that's the hegemonic view,
que existe a visão
that we are in an ecological nightmare.
Somos
very few deny it.
Pesadelo ecológico.
Very
poucos
few deny
negam
it.
Isso.
Those who still deny
aqueles
that the world is in an ecological nightmare are now relegated to the margins of respectability.
Está relegado a pesadelo ecológico.
But this recognition
is
predominantly framed around a fantasy of potential possible social, ecological, urban cohesion if we were to succeed in producing a sustainable city.
Produz uma cidade sustentável.
Notion of sustainability invokes primarily two related arguments or perspectives.
Ou perspectivas.
First, one of ecological rationality.
O primeiro é a racionalidade ecológica.
São Paulo is unsustainable because there is an irrational resource use, and that's obviously
por causa da irracionalidade.
But the argument of sustainability says, if we were to be more rational, if we had a more efficient use of our energy, then all would be fine. Don't believe it, it's not correct.
Não acreditem, isso não está certo.
The second related perspective is that this more efficient, rational resource use, whether it's water, energy, or any other resource you might think of, that this more efficient resource use can be achieved.
Pode ser alcançado.
That is in our grasp,
isso está
in our human capabilities,
through
mobilizing technology-mediated efficient management systems.
Com sistemas
good governance
de manejo, boa governança,
will deliver it.
Isso vai entregar, vai permitir isso.
So this is the argument of eco-technocrats
and
arguments of ecological modernization.
E da modernização ecológica.
Occasionally,
ocasionalmente,
these attempts are
essas tentativas
articulated with wider frameworks that do pay attention
com escopos
to wider social ecological networks. Ask questions, where does São Paulo's water come from? What does,
sobre de onde vem a água
what is it that keeps
Paulo?
The air conditioning systems and
o
the lights
é
on? And where does it come from?
And
who suffers and pays
funcione?
To keep the lights burning
luzes,
and the air cooled?
Né? Ou o ar-condicionado, de onde vem isso?
But that's rarely, that's rather unusual,
mas isso é
these perspectives. So what I want to argue is that sustainability is an imaginary fantasy, which is predicated upon the assumption that it's possible to produce a socio-ecological harmony.
De que é possível
and it's also predicated on a particular scientific
e também está baseada num entendimento particular da natureza.
Later I'll talk about nature with a small n.
Com uma, n grande.
Nature,
e há uma grande
n is the nature of scientists,
entre natureza com n maiúsculo
that see it as a
e minúsculo.
Natureza
vista como
and inherently harmonious
singular e inerentemente harmônico.
And through that, of course, questions of equality and of inequality and inequity
are often silenced.
Now, there's another perspective who goes
in
quite important ways against this view.
Que é contra essa visão.
It's one around which this conference was named. That is environmental justice.
Que foi nomeado. É a
and the conditions of widespread
ambiental.
Urban environmental injustices.
Das
it's really a perspective that looks at the distribution of environmental bats. Who doesn't have water? Who is sited next to garbage dumps? Who has to live next to a nuclear power station? Where does the disassembling of our PCs take place?
Onde acontece a desmontagem dos nossos PCs?
The urban environmental justice movement organized, originated in the United States, as many as you undoubtedly know, as a socio-environmental movement, not as an academic perspective, but as a movement.
Foi movimento
that mobilized pretty much what I would call distributional notions of justice, originally, the kind of
Rawlsian
notion
of
justice as fairness.
Justiça como
fairness, which is organized through patterns and mechanisms of distribution.
Como uma forma de tratamento justo.
So it is the existing socio-political organization that allocates
sociopolítica que aloca
environmental goodies and baddies
bens
to different places and contributing to different people.
Ruins,
and if you look at that, we see that
this distribution
pattern
is highly
uneven and unfair.
Bastante injusto e,
the environmental justice movement originally fell down to the race. African Americans
were
landed with a shit.
Por exemplo, eles ficam
while upper class white Americans got the environmental goodies.
As coisas ruins.
It focused very much on procedures.
Os americanos de classe mais alta recebem as coisas boas do ambiente.
Who is involved
quem toma as decisões? Quem
in taking these decisions? Oh, it's because the African Americans are not involved in decision-making procedures that they get landed with the toxic dumps in their backyard. It is a focus on environmental bats,
produtos tóxicos no,
not
no
on
meu,
good environment,
jardim.
And how to produce good environments
então,
for all and everyone.
Para todos.
And it's highly localized in its
isso
original
é
formulations about sort of NIMBYism.
E
if the rich people don't have the shit in their backyards, black people shouldn't have it either.
Os ricos não recebem porcaria no seu jardim. Os pobres também.
But it brought out a number of very important things
há várias coisas muito importantes.
World, worthwhile thinking about.
Que vale a pena,
urban environmental justice is indeed not just about trees and animals
isso não se trata
and
só de
other
árvores,
things natural
animais,
in the city. It's about social life, social ecological life.
Mas,
it's about how social forms and physical processes intertwine. To produce these highly uneven conditions. And that's great. It shows how nature cannot be
isso
understood
como a
separate from
não pode ser entendida separadamente
the social.
De nós, do social.
It also extended very much the notion over the years, extended the notion of injustice. But that's also part of its weakness. It's a strengthening weakness. Is that the injustices became extended ad infinitum.
So,
well, it's not just race. It's about ethnicity. It's about
não
gender.
Só
it's about class.
Etnia,
it's about disability.
Classe,
it's about age.
Idade,
because an old person in São Paulo, it must be quite something
velha em São Paulo,
to get access to the social ecological services that you need.
Ter acesso aos serviços sociais e ecológicos que necessita. A pessoa não recebe
as coisas
kind of boas
ad infinitum sequencing.
Então, há um sequenciamento infinito de vítimas.
Come back to this notion of
e eu vou voltar
victim,
à noção de vítima, porque acho
and
que vale a pena discutir isso. E como eu disse, foca
social, spatial,
em patente de injustiça, uma questão de distribuição. Eu quero postular essa perspectiva
versus,
contra,
against,
ou não contra, na verdade, versus, vis-à-vis. Há uma articulação e uma conversação possível muito interessante entre as duas.
Considered in the context of political ecological
perspective. Da perspectiva político-econômica.
So let me move now to urban
então,
and political
deixa
ecology.
Eu avançar agora para a ecologia urbana e política,
environmental justice,
que é diferente da justiça ambiental. Mas ela se sobrepõe. Simplificando a estrutura.
Urban political ecology
a ecologia urbana política
so much,
foca não
instance,
tanto
on distribution,
na distribuição,
but on the production
mas sim na produção
of socio-environmental inequalities,
da desigualdade
the
socioambiental. Ela, na verdade, está fazendo...
And socio-environmental inequalities
em como
are produced through
ela é produzida através de...
Socio-physical assemblages.
De montagens sociofísicas. Pense
in
numa rede de água na cidade. Não importa. É um processo de montar processos físicos com formas sociopolíticas que produzem uma paisagem caracterizada por processos de inclusão e exclusão e, consequentemente, desigualdades.
That is the focus of
esse é o foco
political ecology.
Da, da ecologia urbana e política.
Nature,
então, eu estou invocando uma
ecology,
natureza
about
simples
natures as a
da
highly
ecologia
variegated, highly heterogeneous,
a natureza
often
é altamente heterogênea, frequentemente contraditória, nem sempre boazinha.
That are
é um conjunto de coisas que estão aí fora, como físicas, ecológicas, construtos físicos, ecológicos.
Water,
para
CO2,
essa natureza,
CO2,
óleo, água, elas ficam cada vez mais envolvidas numa acumulação de capital em um processo sociometabólico. Pensando
energy,
na água, energia, food, comida,
metals,
metais,
any of these sorts,
qualquer recurso, como uma forma de
metabolismo
sociofísico que se torna organizado através de processos de acumulação e circulação de capital.
E é através disso, claro, que
a 21st century urbanity que a urbanidade do século 21 é produzida,
comparable but not identical,
comparável,
to Manchester
mas não idêntica
a Manchester
no século 19.
Ecological configuration was
characterized by the
local dynamics associated with
local associada
structure primarily with India.
Estrutura
that's today not any longer the case with places like São Paulo. Brazil doesn't have colonies. Yeah, remember?
Não tem colônias.
That doesn't mean, of course, that São Paulo's political ecological structure is not one that is globally networked.
Que a estrutura política e econômica e ecológica não
seja unscrew it, I would find.
Então, se nós
silicon chips
dissolvermos
that undoubtedly come from China,
encontraremos
Guangdong,
chips
put together by little girls of 16, 17
que são montados
in those mass factories,
meninas nessas fábricas de massa, crianças
Delta,
e o Rio Delta
making $10 an hour if they're lucky.
E lá elas ganham
so urbanization today is predicated upon the incorporation of natures.
E
a variety of kinds within the social relations of property and ownership and appropriation of
nature pela,
is predicated
pela
upon
propriedade
the commodification
da natureza
of natures,
e da
the commodification of everything.
Da natureza, commodificação das evidências.
And as just said, present forms of urbanity
disse,
or the spatial
formas presentes da urbanidade ou a
natures
forma espacial na qual a natureza se torna envolvida.
This perspective, urban, the political
essa
ecology is also radically
anti-Malthusian. É anti-Malthusiana.
It's of course silly to say that the world is not finite.
É louco dizer
that's
que o mundo não
silly.
É finito. Isso é estúpido.
That in itself is not
isso
a Malthusian argument.
Não é um argumento malthusiano.
The urban political ecological argument argues that scarcity
o argumento urbano
is a socially produced and socially mobilized
categorically produzido e mobilizado.
That is produced under the twin imperative
é
of accumulation for accumulation's sake on the one hand and the market as an allocation instrument on
pela
the other.
Acumulação.
Without scarcity,
sem
markets
escassez,
do not exist.
Não existem.
That's paragraph 1 of introductory textbook of classical economics.
Esses resultados.
And therefore, needless to say, the urban socio-physical environment embodies and reflects the power relations
socio-físico, ele
in this socio-ecological
metabolism o poder, a relação de poder
of and that choreographs
no metabolismo socioecológico,
who owns natures,
e controla,
who
tem a propriedade sobre a natureza, tem acesso à natureza,
and their
as suas qualidades de recursos,
and
a sua utilização e sua distribuição.
In this configuration,
nesta configuração, os estados e as políticas
matter.
Obviamente fazem uma diferença.
However,
no entanto,
it is class and other forms of social power,
é a classe e outras
gender,
formas de poder
race,
social
that are vital.
Que são vitais.
It is those that express
são
the
eles
conflict
que expressam o conflito
over who has
sobre quem
the
tem
right
o direito
to what kind
a que tipo
of urban nature
de natureza urbana.
This process of the urbanization
esse
of nations,
processo da urbanização das naturezas,
pensem functioning of a city like São Paulo,
como isso
and a kind
funciona numa cidade como São Paulo,
of
há uma mobilização global de naturezas que torna essa cidade sustentável dentro do sentido do mundo em que isso funciona.
So the urbanization
de alguma forma.
Of nations
então,
is
a urbanização da natureza é
multi-escalonada.
Então, se você olha para
the ecology of urban water,
ou a ecologia política da água urbana, é bastante óbvio como a água local, a água regional, se funde com o capital local, regional e global. A água de Londres é de propriedade de um fundo de investimentos australiano, aqueles que ferraram o sistema financeiro há alguns anos.
So the urban political ecological is never just local.
A ecologia urbana nunca é local, ela é sempre translocal e frequentemente global.
Most importantly,
mais importante ainda,
socio-ecological transformations,
a transformação socioecológica que está mudando isso é um ato político.
Therefore, I want
portanto,
to insist,
eu quero insistir,
and I'll conclude with that,
e eu vou concluir
soon,
com isso,
that we have to move from
que nós temos que
ecological perspective
olhar para isso de uma perspectiva
político-econômica, processes through which socio-ecological transformation
no, na política para uma transformação socioeconômica sendo
this
orquestrada.
Political emphasis,
essa ênfase
I would
política,
argue,
eu argumento,
is one that should not foreground justice
não deve estar à frente da justiça ou injustiça como um imperativo
but
ético,
but
mas
equality,
deve ter seu foco
as
na
a
igualdade como um gesto político
so
básico, fundamental. Se
is
querem lembrar uma coisa da minha
let's
fala,
think
é
critically about invoking
vamos
notion of justice and ask yourself
na
why we
da
do not or very rarely invoke
e por que nós raramente invocamos a igualdade socioeconômica como o escopo de que está que baseia aquilo que nós pelo qual nós estamos falando aqui.
To conclude,
então, para concluir,
my argument is one that calls for the repoliticization,
vai em prol
for repoliticizing
da repolitização
urban political ecology.
A ecologia urbana
that's why
e política.
I put a subtitle that we have to try to move from urban environmental movements articulated on questions of justice and injustice. However important that is,
urbano,
I'm not critiquing that as wrong.
Just argue that we have to move from that
to try to articulate
things
around what I would call eco-political demands.
Demandas ecopolíticas.
As an introduction to this,
então,
I would argue that we have failed.
Eu diria também que
and
nós
by we,
falhamos.
I mean
critical
theorists
teóricos, críticos,
of socio-environmental justice
envolvidos
and
em questões de justiça
because we know how it works.
Socioambiental, porque nós sabemos
we
como
do
funciona.
Understand
nós entendemos
the dynamic of socio-ecological inequalities and injustices. We may argue whether it's class or race or ethnicity or gender, which is the most important.
É gênero, classe,
but don't tell
enfim,
me we do not know.
Mas não me digam que nós não sabemos.
Yet,
e, no entanto,
it has done very little in terms of really transforming the socio-ecological
coordinates as
of
coordenadas socio-ecológicas da vida.
So we have to think more
então, nós
political.
Temos que pensar mais em termos políticos.
To turn our socio-environmental analysis,
transformar
which is very, very good,
nossa análise socio-ecológica, que é muito boa, em ações políticas, nas quais nós não
this
somos
requires
tão bons.
Thinking the political.
Então, é por isso que eu falo em
and the political
que
is thinking something
político.
Very different from thinking governance
muito diferente do que pensar em política de governança, em manejo, gerenciamento.
That's a form of organizing
é
the political.
Forma de organizar o
we can't even think
nós
the political any longer without starting to talk about good governance.
Sem conseguir sem começar a falar de boa governança, participativa ou não.
And we have to think again
temos que
about
pensar
what
de novo
the democratic
sobre
political is.
O que é o político democrático que
is predicated upon the presumption of equality of each and everyone.
Da igualdade entre todos.
That the assumption of democracy is that we're equal.
O pressuposto de democracia.
So I think we have to fall ground
então,
that notion of social ecological
nós temos que ter à
equality
a noção
as a democratic
de igualdade
injunction.
Política e social e ecológica como a base da
so
nossa
pointers of things we
então,
might want to
coisas que nós
think
podemos
about.
Querer levar em conta.
That is first of all to think of urbanization as a process of urbanizing global environments.
De urbanizar ambientes globais.
As I've already said several times now, globalization is not something in the abstract. It takes place through concrete social ecological assemblages.
Of which Sao Paulo,
Shanghai,
Delhi
are prime examples in the 21st century.
Shanghai, São Paulo, Delhi,
is a process
Delhi,
of continuous territorialization and
de-territorialization
of these metabolic circulatory flows. Do you know where your computer
circulante?
Ends up?
Você sabe
when you buy a new one after Bill Gates
came
up with Windows 7 and you can't run your software
any longer,
do you know where it ends
depois
up?
Que Bill Gates inventou a Microsoft, você sabe onde vai parar
it's
o seu
a process, as
velho?
I said, that is orchestrated, but we don't
que eu já disse,
fully understand it
orquestrado, mas
to the commodification and financialization.
Até a comodificação
I've heard a lot about the commodification
eu já falei,
of water
já ouvi muito
and the struggles
sobre a comodificação da água
around that.
E a luta
I've heard very
disso.
Little
eu
about the financialization
sobre a financialização
of H2O.
Do H2O.
The financialization
a
of CO2.
Do CO2.
The financialization
a financialização
of waste.
Do resíduo.
And how that links to the global financial architecture and the desperate attempts of the world's elites to keep it intact. So one of the demands, I would argue, we should think about is the demanding the right to the city. This is reviving Henri Lefebvre's clarion call again, that equality today is about the right to the city.
Em termos de
but not just the city as a social space,
cidade, mas não como,
but also
como espaço social,
as an ecological space, as a metabolic vehicle.
Ecológico e como veículo metabólico.
Secondly, we have to think
em
through
segundo lugar, nós temos que pensar
what the post-neoliberalization of urban environments is all about.
O que é a
neoliberalization is now dead.
Neoliberalização.
Capitalism and globalization, of course, is alive and kicking.
O capitalismo está morto. Agora, o capitalismo está vivo e está pulsando.
Neoliberalism, as we know, was already a project
como sabemos,
of wholesale privatization and commodification of everything.
E comodificação
that's
de
why
tudo
we environmentalists got interested in that.
Because
not the only thing that was commodified and privatized,
porque
but nature's was.
A única
as a political
coisa que era
project,
comodificada, mas
as
sim
a clear
natureza
project,
era um projeto claramente
very
político,
well understood.
E isso hoje é bastante bem entendido.
But today,
mas hoje,
we have become all Keynesians, haven't we? Today's post-neoliberal
hoje,
capitalism
o capitalismo
and globalization
is
one that is articulated around state authoritarianism. It is what Slavoj Žižek calls capitalism with Asian values.
É o capitalismo
the most
com
successful
valores
forms
asiáticos.
Of capitalist urbanization is China.
A forma mais bem sucedida é a China, dessa
and still the classic
capitalismo
neoliberal. Of one of the most authoritarian states.
É dos estados mais autoritários.
Consider then how today's
então,
state
como hoje, o estado
is really a socialist
é realmente
state.
Estado socialista.
We have to be very, very careful, therefore, if
e
you want to think of struggles
isso,
of decommodification,
em lutas de decommodificação,
whether the state is indeed a proper form.
É realmente uma
I
forma
to which to articulate that, because
então
today's state,
isso,
I would insist,
o
is a proper socialist state.
É Estado socialista, propriamente.
But it's a socialism for the elites,
mas é
socialismo as Paul Villeneuve
para
called
as elites.
We all know that about $1.5 trillion has been mobilized by the states worldwide to make sure that the circulatory flow of money and the mobilization of nations through this flow could go on.
E assegurar que esse
the capitalism can be sustained
continuar.
For some time longer, and the state is now absolutely vital in that.
E o Estado é absolutamente vital em sustentar o capitalismo.
And that, I would say, brings out the question of democratization and
de-democratization. Da democratização e da
and how to think about who has the right to the metabolic vehicle that the city is, and whether the state, in its traditional 20th century form, is still the proper medium to think that through.
É o meio adequado para
so
pensar
my second
isso.
Point is that we have to try to reclaim
é
democracy
tentarmos
as a foundational political gesture. Think about what democratic socio-ecological configurations
então,
are about.
Pensar nas configurações socio-ecológicas, o que elas
to
são.
Move on to
terceiro,
doing.
Para a ação, para fazer.
Because progressive socio-ecological transformation resides in the political act, not of course in discourses
político.
Like this.
Não em discursos
this is just a spectacle
aqui.
That we participate in for a few days, important as it may be,
por mais importante
but this is not a place where
seja,
the world has changed.
Porque esse é lugar onde se muda
but
o
we do think about it, we have to think about it, that's our role,
pensar.
That's our task,
é essa nossa tarefa.
As
esse
urban
é o nosso papel
ecological
como
intellectuais
ecológicos
so if
urbanos.
I think of urban environmental
então,
movement, by no means all of them, I am massively simplifying here, but I think we have to think
massivamente, mas nós temos
is that many of them are
cuidado.
Reactionary.
Muitos são reacionários.
In the literal sense of the word,
no sentido literal da palavra.
Is that they protest against
eles
something that is happening
contra algo que está acontecendo
them.
Com eles.
In that sense, they react to
ou seja, eles reagem
a change.
A uma mudança.
That is presumably out of their control, and which is often
presumivelmente
but makes them inherently reactionary.
And
therefore, I hate to say inherently conservative.
E por isso eu detesto dizer, mas são inerentemente
they're very often intensely localized, although by no means all. Many are experimenting in very innovative ways which trans-scale the
network. Muitos fazem experimentos de formas muito inovadoras.
They often quite successfully
são frequentemente
organize and mobilize
what
some, around what some have called repertoires of action,
articulate
a notion of victimhood and grievances. Each time I have students coming up who want to do a master's thesis or a PhD with me, and you know, well-meaning students, they do what I call a global environmental scan. They try to take a map and say, where can I find some people who have some grievances and who are victims? And then go off and do another study of the mechanisms of resistance that are articulated on these grievances. It's a politics of victimhood.
Isso é
it's one that is articulated around, endless,
at infinitum,
definition of victims.
A definição de
I don't think that's good enough.
Eu não acho que isso seja suficiente.
And finally, urban environmental movements often clearly disavow or symptomatically blind for the
cegos.
Inherent conflicts and power relationships
inerentes e
that choreograph and articulate movements like that.
Que podem articular movimentos como
so
esse.
My call, third call, would be
então,
to move away from
é
putting urban environmental movements on a pedestal, however important they are, but to move our gaze from those to the need and the thinking around to multi-scalar and to relational, ecological, political demands.
Das demandas políticas em múltiplas
such as, for example,
escalas.
The climate justice
por
movement
exemplo,
tries to do. Although I don't like the word justice in it, the kind of innovative tactical strategies they engage in, I find quite appealing and promising.
Em que eles se engajam, que eu acho
desperately failed.
Apesar de terem falhado desesperadamente em Copenhagen, para fazer passar a sua mensagem e ser que ela fosse incluída na agenda. E finalmente,
and perhaps most importantly,
e talvez mais importantemente,
is that we have to believe again,
nós precisamos acreditar
really believe
de novo, realmente acreditar
that the world, that is socio-ecologically more equal, is possible and realizable. That's where we fail most.
Igual é possível e é aí que
we
nós
know
mais
the world
falhamos.
Is unjust,
nós sabemos
socio-ecologically
que o mundo
speaking.
É
injusto, but we don't believe, really.
Ecologicamente falando, mas nós não
something
acreditamos
else.
Realmente
it's really possible.
Que algo diferente seja realmente possível.
And by actually articulating
e ao articular
our belief,
nossa crença,
vague beliefs in a better world around questions of nature,
no mundo melhor,
capital letter N,
sem questionar
sustainability,
a
capital
natureza,
letter S.
A sustentabilidade
water, capital letter
com
W,
e a água,
is exactly
todas com letra
a
maiúscula,
symptom of
é exatamente um sintoma disso.
Because they're all empty signifiers.
Water,
as we know, is the source
vazios.
Of all life. But as we also well know, is the source of death, too.
E esses, como
there's
sabemos,
nothing inherently
são fontes
good or bad about water. It depends
vida,
how it's socio-ecologically
e mas também
mobilized.
Podem ser fontes de morte, e tudo depende de como são
that's
mobilizados
I,
socioecologicamente.
With Badiou and others,
é por isso
we call ecology
que eu
the new opium of the people.
E outros chamamos a ecologia
it's
como o um novo ópio do
fear.
Povo.
If we don't do something, the world is going to disappear. That's what Al Gore tells us, isn't it?
O mundo
in
vai
inconvenient
desaparecer.
Truth.
É isso que o Al Gore
would you consider
diz.
Al Gore to be the great social environmental
vocês
egalitarian activist?
O Al Gore como grande not. Ativista da igualdade socioecológica? Claro que não.
Ecological coherence.
Coerência ecológica.
Proposed as a panacea
é proposta como
to produce
uma panaceia
good, equal,
para produzir
and just society.
Uma sociedade
it's missing
boa
the point. Yes, ecology matters. Massively,
but
you achieve that to political aims, not by studying social environmental injustices. So however important that is.
Estudar a injustiça socioecológica.
The ecological argument invites radical change.
Ecológico,
that's why it's so appealing for those people. We have to change
radical.
Radically.
É preciso
our technological, organizational, governmental structure. Otherwise, the world's going to burn down in overheating.
Vai,
but what kind of radical change has to happen according to the goals of this world? What kind of radical change has to happen according to Prince Charles, who said last year in Chile?
Que tem que acontecer,
we have 100 months left.
Que disse lá em
that's
no Chile,
88 months
temos
left, said it last
100
year.
Meses ainda.
Does he want to
ele,
produce a truly social, ecologically equal society?
Uma sociedade realmente
no.
Igualitária?
He wants to sustain
não.
The order as we know it.
Ele quer sustentar
with
a ordem como sabemos.
With its inequalities.
Como nós conhecemos, com suas injustiças, com suas desigualdades.
That's why.
E é por isso
this kind of radical change
que eu convido
sure really
o convite para essas mudanças radicais são para assegurar
so
que nada mude.
Ecological intellectuals,
então,
socio-ecological intellectuals, we have to
nós, como intelectuais socio-ecológicos, precisamos usar
if
novamente
really
nossa
believe,
imaginação. Se nós realmente acreditamos que pode
think
ser feito,
to do how, in a
como,
proactive way.
De uma forma proativa.
Just borrowed this from David Sori this morning when we were having a conversation about this.
Eu estava conversando com David.
In a proactive way, how we can
produce
social ecological equality.
Igualdade socioecológica.
And that requires
isto requer
mobilizing our intellectual imaginaries. Again,
nossa imaginação
in ways that suggest that
de novo,
we really
de
believe
formas que sugerem que nós realmente
that
acreditamos que um mundo de igualdade socioecológica é possível. E é por isso que demandas para basear a igualdade como a chave, o fator-chave em torno do qual viver e agir. Muito obrigado.